Hello everyone, and thank you for using Danomics. In this video, I'm going to be reviewing the functionality and capabilities of the Inversion module. To get to the Inversion module, come to the Central Module Selection drop-down menu and choose Inversion. In the Inversion module, you'll notice that the display for the parameters is different than that seen in other modules. You'll notice that it is a matrix type display. So let's walk through this matrix. In each column on the left-hand matrix, we have our minerals. For example, we have quartz, calcite, dolomite, pyrite, clay, kerogen, water, and oil by default. On the right-hand matrix, we have our curves, how we want to fit the curves in the inversion, and how we want to weight the curves with the confidence interval. Each of the rows are the expected log responses for that curve. For example, the density response in a calcite is expected to be 2.71, and the density response in a dolomite is expected to be 2.87. And we continue doing this on a row-by-row basis for neutron, sonic, conductivity, and so on. It should be noted that in most cases, there's very little flexibility in the mineral properties. These are generally well understood. However, with some minerals such as clay, such as your clays, kerogen, and your fluids, you can see substantial deviations away from the defaults. When setting up your mineral module, you'll notice that first we have here where it says zone, you can choose default. In general, for our default model, what we want to do is select the minerals that make up the bulk of our mineralogy. In the case of these wells, there's very little dolomite or pyrite in most of our intervals. We can then turn that off. However, if we wish to customize this for certain zones, such as the Niobrara, where we know that pyrite is present, or the Mowry, which is another organic shell where we know that pyrite is present, we can turn it on specifically for those zones. If we wish to change how a curve is being used, we come here to our default zone, and we can choose, for example, to turn on conductivity as a fit, and then we can give it a weight. To QC this plot, you can come here and look at our actual curves shown in black versus the predicted curves shown in red. You can see that we have at present a misfit between our neutron and our sonic curves. If we adjust some of our properties, such as the neutron value of our clay and the sonic value of our clay, we can see that we get significantly better fits. We can also adjust the conductivity of our clay in this case, since we have enabled that method. Once you are satisfied with the quality of your model as QC'd from the actual versus reconstructed curves, you can then evaluate the main outputs, which are the grain density from the inversion and the sum of the fluids, which gives us a total porosity. Okay, that is a very high-level view of how to use the mineral inversion module in Danomics. If you'd like to learn more or go into more depth on how to use this module, please contact us at support@danomics.com. Thank you.